My name is Christos Leonidopoulos. I'm a lecturer and a Chancellor's Fellow at the University of Edinburgh. I'll talk to you about the experimental evidence that establishes the standard model, in particular, the experimental searches for the Higgs, starting from the LEP, the Tevatron, finally to the LHC. What does it really mean that we have discovered the Higgs boson? What does a Higgs boson look like? Do we actually see the Higgs appear in front of our eyes? Not exactly. There are several obstacles that make the experimental observation of the Higgs boson a very difficult problem. First of all, producing the Higgs is not something that is easily done. We do this by colliding proton beams at the LHC in Geneva at very high energies. But we don't produce a Higgs every time there is a collision. Why not? This cannot be explained with classical physics. Quantum mechanics introduces the notion of non-deterministic behavior in the interactions between particles, and it even allows us to calculate the probability for creating a new particle. The probability for creating a Higgs at the LHC is about once for every billion collisions. So, producing the Higgs is not something that happens very often. To make things worse, every time the Higgs is produced, it vanishes right away by decaying to other particles.
Right away means 10 to the minus 22 seconds, or a tenth of a thousandth of a billionth of a second, a very short time.
So we never actually get to see the Higgs in front of our eyes. The best we can hope for is to observe the fragments of the decay products inside the detector and try to make sense of them. Let's see how this happens.
Protons travel inside this beam pipe. They are moving extremely fast, basically at the speed of light. This is an artist's representation of a proton containing three quarks moving towards a head-on collision with another proton. We're obviously in slow motion here. Our proton is approaching the detector, and if everything goes well, it should smash against another proton. You see the two protons coming from both sides, and they are synchronized to collide inside the heart of the detector. When you have a powerful collision like this, you expect fragments to come out in all directions and your detector to be able to record these signals. And it is by putting these decay products together that you hope to reconstruct what happened at collision time and understand if they look consistent with the decay of a new particle.
This is much better explained by looking at the distribution of the reconstructed mass of the decay products as a function of time. This particular plot is made when we combine two photons and examine if they are consistent with the decay of a Higgs particle. You can see that as we add data, the distribution grows in size. Most of this is the background, indicated by the blue curve. If there is a Higgs, it should appear as an extra peak located at a given value, the mass of the Higgs. It is very difficult to find such a peak on top of a large background. One thing that we do is to make another plot with the average background subtracted, and you can see this at the bottom. As we add more data, you see small upward and downward fluctuations in several places, but these go away after a while. Everywhere, except for around 125 GeV. This peak does not go away. It looks like a new particle. This is a similar plot from what we call a different decay channel, in which the reconstructed mass is calculated by combining four leptons together. This channel has a much more complex background, indicated with the red and the purple colors. It is almost impossible to spot the Higgs, unless you look at the bottom background subtracted plot. And again, not only can you see a clear peak, but it is at the same place that it was in the two-photon plot shown before, around 125 GeV. Two different channels, two clear peaks, at the same place. 125 GeV, which is the mass of the Higgs.